Hi everyone, so I thought you might like to have a look at how HTC's Gallery app works on the HTC One. Now it has a couple of sort of key features. It will obviously bundle together all of your images you take each day and videos into a single kind of small album. And then what it will do is it will use its various effects that it has from the camera, from the Duo camera, to kind of, well, add a little bit of extra zing to things. So for instance, with its automated video that we have here, let's just go into that. What it will do is it's taking all of the various images I've taken this day and it's then rounding them up into a nice little video, which it will then add duo effects to if a duo picture was taken. So this can include blurring out the background, creating this really cool kind of 3D effect from the depth of field on the camera, and just generally giving you a nice snapshot, auto awesome, really, trademark Google, of all of your activities that day that you've captured. But likewise, if you want to, you can go in and have a look at individual images quite easily. You just scroll down slightly and we can come into here and let's just find a picture of, let's have this one. So here's our image. And if I want to, I can come in and I can edit that image. And this is where we can then add in our various effects. So we've got the U focus option here, which allows me to pick a point of focus and have the focus then altered to move to that position. Oops, I just want to come back out of that because I need to be able to add a different effect. I may have just made a mistake there. Yes, I have. Oh, damn it. But likewise, we can go into another image, and if we want to, we can throw on our duo effect. So to do this, we have various options. So the U focus is one of them. There's foreground, a seasoned, Dimension Plus. Now, Dimension Plus is probably one of the cooler features because watch this. Because of the way the dimension camera works, it's maybe not the best image to kind of do this with. You can have this kind of 3D effect because the second camera is offset slightly. It's able to kind of see past the object you're taking a picture of, and so you can have some additional depth information. Let me just see if I can find a better image than that one. As you can see, it was a very dark day when I took these photos. It doesn't really do the best by the camera, sadly. But let's just try this one. Not this one, it's the other one. This one. Unfortunately, once you've edited an image with the Duo options and saved it, you then lose the ability to kind of add any more features to it. But if you watch the fish, you can see how well this kind of works in practice. When you have the right kind of image for the Duo camera, it works exceptionally well. It's incredibly cool. But as you can see on the top of the fork, you can get some kind of warping and bending occurring on straighter objects. It's one of those things where it doesn't work in all cases and all scenarios, but it's kind of cool effect. How much use it's actually going to be long term, that all depends on whether HTC give us an easy way to share that effect with a wide range of people. At the moment, this content is very much locked to the device, unfortunately. So, within the gallery, there's so many different kind of options from an editing point of view. Let's go into one of these options and take images and take a look at the options that we get. So if we come into edit, we've got the effects that I've already gone through a moment ago. And those also include like stickers and copying and pasting and a touch up for people's faces as well. And they're really quite useful features, although I'm not too sure how useful the skin smoothing option is going to be. It's a little bit like kind of photoshopping people in Vanity Fair. It's a bit of a strange one. We also have access to a range of different filters. These filters can also be added at shooting time as well, I believe. So we can go in here and we can adjust our saturation and so on. We also have the ability to add frames. These frames can be a variety of funny looking things or effects. And we also have a tool set here as well. And this allows us to straighten up the image if we want to, crop the image, rotate the image, or draw directly onto the image as well. This is all pretty standard stuff, but it's not a bad package, as it were, for a gallery app. Normally we would have to, you know, go and grab some other apps like Snapseed and so on. So it's quite nice that HTC obviously put a lot of effort in here. Sharing your content is equally easy, but just bear in mind you won't be getting hold of any of those really cool 3D effects, as it were, when you try and share, simply because they're kind of locked into the video footage itself. I'll be looking for an alternative way, if we can, before the Zoe app launches, that we can try and share that information. Perhaps we can try and just render them on screen and export them, but we will see. Thanks for watching. We hope you enjoyed this video. Do please remember to like and comment, and if you'd like to, please subscribe. You can also visit our website and download our Android app. If you do subscribe, you'll be getting a daily dose of the latest tech news, hardware reviews, Android games, consoles, and basically an honest opinion direct from the UK. Stay tuned. Stay Androidizen.